Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me? I'm feeling a tad politically incorrect because today I am going to label things. I know people say it's not politically correct to label things, but I am going to, and you are going to, because we're going to look at labels and filters in Gmail. We're also going to discuss notifications in Google Calendars and discuss the difference between Dropbox and Evernote. All of that coming up today on Ask Dotto Tech. Ask Dotto Tech is the show where you ask, I answer. If you have questions that you'd like me to address, please, please, please enter them in the YouTube comments, or you can drop us an email if you're signed up for our newsletter. Just reply to our newsletter with your question, and I will do my best to answer. I cannot answer each and every question, but I do my best to answer as many as possible. Today, we're going to start things out with a pair of questions from Salve236 and Noah York, who asked me two questions about Gmail, which I cleverly combined into a single demo that we will do. The first one was, he asked if he can create filters with multiple keywords within Gmail. And the second question from Noah York was, how do I get labeled emails to show in my inbox? Two questions, both relating to Gmail, obviously. So let's jump over into Gmail and have a wee gander at those issues. So the first question was about filters. Now, you have to understand that we have two different kind of, there are two different things going on here. We have email filters, which automatically go through and categorize email. Gmail looks at your email coming in, and it creates an action based on the attributes of that email, who it's from, what it is, that sort of thing. And then it applies a label to it, moves it to a certain spot, deletes it, it can do all sorts of things like that. The second part is the identification for you, is the labeling. We can create labels for all of our different groups of emails for, and then so that we can quickly visually identify what's happening with the email when it comes into our inbox. It's all about increased productivity, folks. So let us have a wee look. And it all starts right here in the settings. If I go into the settings, I will find there both labels, which we're not going to deal with the labels here, but instead we're going to start by dealing with filters. So the filters are how we create a set of rules that tell an email how to act. So you can create a new filter from scratch just by going here and going through and creating the filters and putting in the different criteria. And one of the things with the question that was asked is, can we create a filter with multiple keywords? Right here, you can have create the filter with multiple keywords. So the criteria are who it's from, who it's to, the subject, if it's got the words, or if it doesn't have certain words in it, and then you can add other criteria as well. It's kind of labor intensive though to create a filter here in this dialog box or in this area here. Instead, the best place to go to create filters is when you're in an email of the sort that you want to have filtered. So if I go into my promotions tab here, this is my demo account, so there's very little real email. But if we wanted to say create a filter for all of the Dotto Tech newsletters, which seems to be the only email that comes to this particular account, what you can do is you can have the email opened up. Once it's open, you can then, under the More tab, create filter messages like these. So it's going to now pre-populate the basic information. It comes from info@dottotech, and then that's the only criteria that it's given. I can choose a subject. If I have a repeating subject line, I can put that in here. I can put in whether or not it's, I can put in if it's to a certain email address, or include the words. So I'm going to put in the words, has the words Dotto Tech, because I always start out each newsletter with Dotto Tech this week. Once I've got this basic criteria in place, I can click down here in the bottom and say create a filter with this search. So now what it's going to do is, when the message arrives with this, what should I do? Ah, this is where we get into the label question. So I'm going to apply a label, and I'm going to choose a label. But I don't have any labels created yet because I'm just new to this. So I'm going to create a label that's called Dotto Tech Newsletter. So now it will save them all. Now if I've got multiple different labels already, I can nest them in order. But I'm just going to create this as a one that's kind of a top level one. And then I can also add other criteria. I can forward it to a certain email address. I can delete it. I can mark it as important, or I can categorize it into different areas here within the predefined categories within Gmail. So I can also, this is a little bit of magic, apply this to all the matching messages. So when I create this filter now, it's going to take all of those existing messages and it's going to create a filter. And look here, now I created a brand new area in my sidebar, which is the Dotto Tech newsletters, which has all of those Dotto Tech newsletters available. Isn't that sweet? Now, as far as identifying them now as within the inbox, being able to identify them as having this label, the best way to do that is to actually choose the label color right from here. See this little drop-out menu or a pop-out menu? This allows me to choose all of these messages and apply a label color to them. So now when we go back into our inbox, if I'm correct, we should, yes, have the blue badge identifying all of these as Dotto Tech newsletters. So that's how we create the order and structure. First of all, by creating a filter, which applies the rules, and then creating a label, which allows us to see it and identify it visually or by sorting ourselves within the inbox. I hope that that answers your questions, guys. So for Salve236 and Noah York, thanks for asking. I hope that I've answered it to your satisfaction. Our next question comes from my friend Ivor Greer, who asks, why do you store everything in Evernote when you already use Dropbox? Here we have again the Evernote conundrum. People not quite understanding how Evernote fits compared to other services, because Evernote is totally unique. Dropbox is storage. Dropbox is virtual storage that's online. It allows me to access files wherever I am from my mobile device or mainly from different desktop or notebook computers. It's great for file sharing, but it's not my digital memory. It's not where I store all the little tidbits of information that I put into Evernote. For example, if we take a look right here, right now I'm working with the little notes that I clip from the questions. This is an Evernote note that has all of my Ask Dotto Tech questions. I use Evernote to clip stuff from the web. I use it to take pictures of receipts and invoices. I use it for all of my different, anytime that there's a digital asset that I need to retain, I put in Evernote. Dropbox is very, very different. Dropbox is just like another hard drive that lives on our computer. Here's my Dropbox account right here. And you can see that I have a variety of different folders, some of them shared, some of them not. But this is just access to files. I have to create an organizational structure within Dropbox. Within Evernote, when I need to find something, I simply search for it. I can search within Evernote and I don't have to worry about saving it as a file, etc. I just clip it and save it within Evernote and it's done. So I don't know if I've explained this well, but Dropbox is just an extension of my local storage, of my hard drive. Yes, there are some additional collaborative features and sharing features that Dropbox enables, because the fact that the content is stored on the cloud allows us to create sharing with coworkers or with other people and also to work collaboratively in documents. And you can do some of those things within Evernote, but it is primarily for files. Here's a great example. These videos that I create, sometimes I'm editing them on this computer, sometimes I'm editing them on a different computer. Here's all of my different assets that I would want to import, things like my opening music and credits and all of those sorts of things. I store those in Dropbox so that I can access them regardless of which computer I'm on. That wouldn't be appropriate to store in Evernote because it wouldn't be a quick way to get it out. But if it's something that I needed to archive to find later, Evernote then becomes that solution. So Dropbox and Evernote are not mutually exclusive. You don't decide to use one at the expense of the other. Dropbox is for file storage and sharing. Evernote is for everything that I need to gain access to that's a digital asset at any time. I hope that that answers your question, Ivor. And our final question for this episode of Ask Dotto Tech comes from Melinda Nazim, who asks, what's the best app for using Google Calendar on the Mac desktop so the calendar reminders pop up? I'm not a fan of any real calendar app that's outside of the Google Calendar itself. Melinda, what I like to do is just to use the Google tools, the Google productivity tools, in a browser instance. I like to use Gmail in my browser, and I like to use Google Calendar in the same browser. I think that that's the most effective way to use it. Now, as far as giving you reminders and giving you pop-ups and stuff like that, If we go into the settings, let's just jump over into my calendar here and go into the settings. Let me show you where the reminder settings are so you can understand what sort of reminders you have access to and how you manage them, because we can do it all right from within the browser window here. By the way, I'm running the Chrome browser here on the Mac, but it's exact same if you're in Safari. If you go into your calendar settings, so going under that gear icon and into calendar settings, we go to calendars, and here under each, with each calendar, and I've got, as you can see, I have multiple different calendars that I have running in my calendar set settings. I can go into edit notifications, and in edit notifications, I can set the different parameters for all of the different types of notifications that I'm going to receive on my computer or in email. Look here, email notifications. So I can event notifications. By default, notify me via pop-up or email 10 minutes before each event. So you just set your pop-ups, reminders, right here. And then you can go through this, and you can also choose how you're going to do all day notifications. You can also choose to be kept up to date by email through new events, changed events, canceled events, event responses, and actually one of my favorite, I don't have it turned on, but I know a lot of people like it, and I think it's a great idea, receiving an email at 5 in the morning of every of your agenda for the entire day. I think that's a great way to do things. If you like to see your day at a glance and you don't necessarily want to open the browser and you don't want to have, you don't want to be online, just receiving it in your email and being able to read an email that has your daily agenda is a great way to stay on track. So as you can see, you have lots of different control about how you receive notifications from your Gmail calendar right within the browser. And with that, I think we have come to the end of another Ask Dotto Tech. Once again, if you do have a question for me, two good ways to ask those questions are A, enter it here in YouTube in the comments area. I respond and check that every day. If I can answer your question, I will answer it right away. If not, it might make it in the show. Some questions we obviously don't have time to answer. The other way to ask us questions is if you've subscribed to our newsletter, just reply to the newsletter with your question and I will receive it by email. And again, I'll do my best to answer or include it here in the show. Now, there's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. Please subscribe to this channel. Also, subscribe to our newsletter. That way you can ask me questions, but also learn about our upcoming live events and webinars and courses. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel supported through the generosity of you, our viewers, at the crowdfunding site Patreon. I encourage you to drop by, take a look, and discover what's involved in supporting Dotto Tech, what we do with the money, and the perks that we have for you. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.